If I traded it all, if I gave it all away.
Welcome back, everyone. You try and do two things at one time. It's not very simple. That's what I'm doing here in this right now. It's been crazy. That's what COVID-19 does.
Truly.
I'll tell you what, I am so excited about bringing on my next guest because she's been on with me several times. I don't know how long it's been now, Carolyn. You've been on my show, Carolyn Rae, and you're the owner of, and it's Professional Claims Management. I want to make sure I say it all. Tell everybody a little bit about yourself, what you do, what you're here for today. We have been promoting this, well, it seems like the last week, but today I promoted it big time all day long that we were talking a little bit about Chip Merlin, who you're going to have on the phone with us. Right. Tell us about yourself, tell us about him, and tell us about who you have with you here, too.
Okay, very good. Hi, Carol. I'm Carolyn, owner of Professional Claims Management. We're a public adjusting firm, and most people don't know what a public adjuster is or that they can have representation on their side as they go through a insurance claim. Whether they're a homeowner or a business owner, we handle any type of insurance claim, first party for fires, pipe bursts, tree falling through your roof, hail damage, and
earthquakes.
Now, earthquakes.
Remember?
Sure, we could. We could. Absolutely.
I lost my house in that Northridge earthquake, and I only wish that I knew that I could call a public adjuster.
Right. You would have done so much better.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
But today we want to focus on the COVID-19 and business interruption for all of those business owners out there that who have brick and mortar, they can't open their business, maybe they're a restaurant and they're running at 10% capacity, whatever the situation is. We wanted to bring that to light today and talk about that during the whole show. That's why we invited Mr. Merlin with us.
So we have Mr. Merlin with us. We also have Michael. Let's introduce him and also your guest.
Antosh is one of the public adjusters at my firm. He's sitting to my right, and Michael is another public adjuster. He is staying safe at home.
Yes, and he is a high risk, so be careful there, Michael. And then also we also have with us Chip Merlin. Chip, welcome to the show.
Hey, it's great to be here this afternoon with you.
And I'm going to let Carolyn, this is going to be like your little show here right now, just talk a little bit about Chip and why you brought him on. And he wrote a book here. We've got your book that you've written, which is Pay Up, Preventing a Disaster with Your Own Insurance Company. Let's talk a little bit about this.
Right, okay. So I invited Chip to so that we could discuss the business interruption coverage that you may or may not have on your policy and what you need to do to see if you do have that type of coverage on your policy. Chip is the owner of Merlin Law Group. They're a national law firm that fights for policyholders. And he recently wrote this book. So one of the things we're going to be doing today is giving away a couple of copies.
Well, we're going to open up the lines for people to have that. It's called Pay Up, Preventing a Disaster with Your Own Insurance Company. It's a Forbes book. So our number here is 602-277-5369. And toll free, it's 1-866-536-1100. And I'm going to let everyone get entered in to win. Why would someone want the book?
Chip, that would be that would definitely be
Chip,
something to jump
in on. What's your
on.
Answer to that?
It's a great book to explain how you should go about purchasing your insurance, what you should do after you have an insurance claim, and what type of professionals you might need to have depending upon the type of claim you've got so that you don't end up having a second disaster after the first one, which may hurt you. I mean, sort of like a lot of business owners today are sitting out there from the coronavirus and they're sitting at home because their businesses are shut down, and do they have insurance coverage right now? And the book goes through a detailed explanation of who you should be trying to find out that information and how you can empower yourself so that you can get the best coverage and then make that coverage work for you.
Well, I'm looking at it right now, and I'll tell you something. Bad faith practices of insurance companies is what it starts off with, and a lot of them do. I know for me, and I'm just going to talk here right now, it happened to me. I mean, when I was with the earthquake, it was not a pretty sight for a lot of us out there. It wasn't that easy. Right. And I don't know out there if anybody knows, you don't realize that you can call an adjuster. And you should call your insurance company, but you got to call your an adjuster. And people do not know that you exist. Right. Or I don't know if they just realize that they don't get that they can use you. I don't understand it.
We're the insurance company's biggest secret. They don't want you to know that you can have your own representation.
Mm-hmm. Now, with this book, okay, I want to go back into this. tell your our listeners who may be business owners, what would they do with about their businesses that shut down right now as with commercial insurance, which is something I never even think about.
Well, it's important insurance, and one of the things that people have coverage for, it's right in your business income form of your policy, is civil authority. When acts of a civil authority require you to shut down your business, you're supposed to have coverage for that. And it was so much so that 2 weeks ago today, President Trump was answering a question at a press conference, and he stopped the question, turned the topic around, and then started talking about business interruption coverage. And that when he was in business and there was a hurricane or something like that, and his business got interrupted or shut down, he would make a claim for business income coverage. And so even he didn't understand the reason why the insurance companies weren't paying for this, because there's no exclusion. And he said he read the policy for a pandemic. And indeed, when you read through it, there is not an exclusion for pandemic, but there is an exclusion for virus that's in there for about 50 to 70% of the policies that are sold. So for businesses that are shut down, they have one duty to do right now. And if there are listeners out there and you're a small business owner and you're listening in, call your insurance agent and report the loss. That's the one thing that you can do right now. And after that, you can call a public adjuster like Carolyn to go help take care of your claim and help go get it submitted. But you have an obligation to at least report the loss. And I'm so afraid people won't do that. I'm trying to get that message out.
Oh, I'm so glad you're here.
They have an obligation to do so.
I am so glad you're here, because how many people right now, my mouth is wide open. I had no idea. And the only way you're going to know is by calling your insurance company, right, finding out whether that's in there. And then if it is, again, you go ahead and you can call Carolyn. What happens once they call you now?
Well, actually, let me piggyback on what Chip was just saying about calling your insurance company. We're working with a client in Ohio that owns 13 hotels, and his business is way down. So he called his agent to file claims for those hotels, and his agent discouraged him from doing that.
Why? Oh, I wonder why. Well, why? Of course.
Because the agents work exclusively for the insurance companies. They are the insurance company's agent, not your agent.
Right.
So they are obligated basically repeat whatever the insurance company tells them to repeat in some
and
sense.
We need to tell people, too, because you work on a contingency basis. Why? Again, that's another good reason to do it, too,
sure,
to call you. But the fact is that you're working for them. You are making sure that they get. That's why they're here. That's why you don't hear State Farm here. I'm sorry, but you don't. They're not here saying that you can call us and find out, you know, whether or not you have a claim. It's Carolyn Rae who's doing that right there for you, that says, call in and find out. And if you do, then call Carolyn. Then they take the next steps with you. Am I correct, Chip?
That's exactly what I say in the book. As a matter of fact, I state that, especially for a lot of busy executives, and even though this is what I do for a living, I state in my book that in the event I had a property damage, you think I'm going to be around to deal with the insurance company? No way. Am I an expert in putting together in a claim? No way. I know who to go hire. And I tell people to go hire a quality public adjuster like Carolyn to go, you know, submit their property insurance claim, because typically what they get back in their fee is far in excess of what you would have gotten back had you worked with the insurance company, just because the insurance company often doesn't tell you about all the benefits that are available under the policy and how you go about valuing what you're owed under the insurance policy. Carolyn and people like her who are licensed by the state are experts in this.
We're live on Facebook, so I want to show everybody the book there, too. We can do that. The book is called Pay Up, and it's Preventing a Disaster with Your Own Insurance Company. Call in here, get a copy. Our number here, 602-277-5369, and toll-free, it's 1-866-536-1100. First of all, I said it before about your other book. This one, even so, you're a business owner. You really need this. Anyone really can need this book right now to find out the steps to make sure that you're protected, and that's what it's all about. I'm going to give out some of your information, too, because it's important. We're going to go to a break. Their website, Carolyn's, is onyourside.us. They do second opinions. They do free consultations for everybody. They work for anybody on a contingency basis, and they work nationwide. Their number direct is 480-840-1816. I know me. I'm calling my insurance. Find out right now. If I traded it all, if I welcome back. We are talking right now with Chip Merlin. He's on the phone. We got a lot of people here with us today. And the book that we're talking about right now is his book, Pay Up, Preventing a Disaster with Your Own Insurance Company. It's a Forbes book. We all have our lines here for everyone to call in and get. We want everyone to get entered in to win. We're going to give away a few of them here. Yes. Our number here is 602-277-5369. Toll free, it's 1-866-536-1100. Everyone should be listening to this. Business owners right now, please listen up. So why, Chip, then, doesn't the insurance industry pay these claims?
Well, there's a number of reasons. The first one is that about 50 to 70% of the policies that have been issued have a standard exclusion that started getting issued about 15 years ago after SARS came out that says that they exclude losses caused by virus. And whether or not that's going to be applicable or not, there's already lawsuits and class action lawsuits filed on this particular issue. But getting the notice of loss in there is more than just the lawsuit. It's also because there's federal legislation that's been filed. There's been seven different states that have now filed legislation which may even retroactively change these policies. So between what the courts are going to come out and rule with respect to how these policies ought to be interpreted, things that might happen in the federal legislation, things that might happen in the state legislation, it's important to get in line, so to speak, with respect to putting your carrier on notice. In some states, unlike Arizona, but in some states, if you don't put your insurance carrier on notice right away, you can lose your right to then make the claim later. So if these lawsuits come out favorable, if the federal legislation comes out favorable, if the state legislation comes out favorable, you don't want to lose otherwise benefits that you'd be entitled to because you failed to give notice of the loss.
So you're saying call now.
Absolutely. Call a public adjuster to get them to help you out if you have any problem doing it, but you have to report the loss and you should do it now.
So the first thing is to find out, to call your insurance company and find out, or put the loss there, at least put the claim in, and then you can call Carolyn. The number here is 480-840-1816. I want to get out their website. It's on your side. .us.com. Make sure that you go to that one, and she'll help you out because there's other steps that obviously you have to take, correct?
Yeah, a review of the policy and analysis to see what is, you know, included in there, what's not, keeping an eye on whatever legislation might be coming up.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, and then again, Chip, back to you, all right? So we've read that a number of states have filed legislation regarding retroactively, I'm trying to read these things, changing the business income policies. Can they do this? And if so, what would be their impact?
Well, what some of the state legislatures have done is say we have an extraordinary circumstance right here. And for most of the states, they've gone from record employment. This is the lowest rates of unemployment that we've ever had, mm-hmm. ever. And within 1 month, we've gone from record employment to record unemployment. You know, and as a result of that, and it's all caused by the coronavirus, and much of it's caused as a result of the authorities, whether it be by governor or by various mayors, saying you've got to shut down your business. You're not allowed for people to come down here. And these orders that have gone out, many businesses have been forced to shut down. And so for many business owners, when they read through their policy and they see, gee, it says we have, you know, a coverage for civil authority. The civil authority said, you know, we would get paid for this, and they call in, and then their insurance agent sometimes suggests, oh, you should make a claim for that because, and this is what the insurance company come back and say, oh, the fine print, when you read the fine print, yeah, we said we were going to cover for civil authority, but when you read the fine print, we really don't cover for the civil authority, and that has just aggravated and frustrated small business owners throughout the United States, and that's what's led to a number of the lawsuits, what's led to a lot of the state legislators saying, what we're going to do is we're going to retroactively change the law and do it in such a manner it's not all businesses, but those that have employees of 100 or less, so that they're going to be able to collect their benefits that they reasonably expect we're being able to get under the insurance, and then require insurance companies in the future to insure or clearly define that they're not certainly covering it, you know, in the future. So they have a number of different legislations out in the various states, even at the federal level right now, and it's something to be monitored, as Carolyn was just talking about, because it could be that even if, as these other court cases, you know, take a while to work through, that there might be a legislative resolution to this.
Well, your book, Is do you find that it's a book that somebody ends up reading cover to cover? Is it something like a guide? How do you perceive the book?
Yeah, a lot of people have called back, and I've been surprised that they chip. This sounds just like when you're talking to us, and it doesn't sound like you're talking to a bunch of lawyers. And when I wrote the book, I wanted to make certain it was just the regular person on the street could read it, whether it had to do with their health insurance, their property insurance, and what is it that, and how do we go about purchasing our insurance? How do we pick our insurance agent? You know, and I warn people various things about not trying to do it yourself, and so that when you have a claim, maybe even before you call your insurance agent, you might want to call Carolyn and her experts about, you know, hey, is this even worthwhile? What do we need to do? And things like that. But, you know, picking the right insurance agent, picking the right insurance professional once you have the claim. And then, you know, one of the last things is don't give up. And we even talk about if people want to try to do it themselves, how they can make complaints to the Department of Insurance, and how most departments of insurance have experts even will try to help you out, especially on your health insurance claim. So I think it's an important book that people can read and learn, and learn. And I have a lot of stories in there that will make it come, I think, home why you need these types of professionals to help you out.
The book is called Pay Up, Preventing a Disaster with Your Own Insurance Company. Our number here is 602-277-5369, and toll-free, it's 1-866-536-1100. Carolyn, you know, I'm sitting here and I listen to this and I'm like, oh my God, you know, there's so many people out there. We're all at home. You're all at home right now. Mm-hmm. And a lot of you have been, all we do is hear complaining. You know, we want to go back to Wizard Wonder. But you know what? You've had some losses and you have rights. People, this is what I'm saying, I'm hearing from you. So we have rights and we have our businesses that we might be covered and we don't even know it. And probably a lot of people don't even think about calling. All you're thinking about is getting better right now or making sure that you're protecting
surviving.
Other people and surviving.
Yeah.
But this information is wonderful information for people out there. Live on Facebook, guys out there, that you're hearing this. We've been pushing it all day long. Tell everybody about it. That's what it's all about, how important it is. Call your insurance company first. Find out, or you, if you need to help, you can call also Carolyn, write direct. Her number is 840-841-1816. They work on what?
Close, 840-1816.
That's what I said, 840-1816. I'm going to, what's wrong with me today? I'm having problems. They do second opinions. Also, their website, again, I'll say it right, it's onyoursideus.com. Again, that phone number is 480-840-1816. Chet, real quickly, last question, as fast as I can get it in here. Is the federal government going to get involved? And there seems to be some kind of talk about PIRA, P-I-P-R-I, what is it?
PRIA?
What is it?
PRIA, P-R-I-A.
What is that?
I don't know.
Okay,
Chip?
What is it, Chip?
Well, so if everybody remembers after September 11th and the World Trade Center, there was terrorism that caused all this damage. And after that, to help insurance companies so that they would not exclude acts of terrorism that caused, you know, widespread damage, not just in New York, but throughout the United States as businesses were shut down and things like that, we came up with, you know, Terrorism Risk Insurance Act, TRIA, and now there's discussion about having the same thing for a pandemic, you know, Pandemic Risk Insurance Act. And in both situations, the federal government would act as a backstop. And the insurance industry, if you've read over the last month, they've been saying if we are forced to pay all these insurance claims, we could go bankrupt. And of course, what the insurance companies say all the time when they have to pay in with any claim whatsoever.
Right, they're not going bankrupt.
They'll go bankrupt. And so but they say that it's such a large, massive amount of money. And don't get me wrong, it is a large amount of money that we need a federal program to be a backstop to us, such as like in the flood insurance program, like in the crop insurance program. And so there are other governmental programs that have been set up where the federal government, after a certain amount of money, would be a backstop for the insurance industry if they issued in the future, you know, pandemic risk insurance, which is obviously needed. We need some type of backup for this as we go through this. If this is something that's going to occur with some, you know, every decade, every 20 years, something like that. What is it that we're going to do to have a backup? Hopefully, it'll never happen like this again.
Well, absolutely.
We've learned an awful lot of lessons, but there are going to be instances where if there is a pandemic and there is some response that's going to hurt your particular business, you can get insurance that'll help offset you know, this disaster that a lot of us are going through.
I'll tell you what, guys.
Pockets at the federal level.
Absolutely. Let me just tell you, it starts with us. It starts with us as people listening to this. I'm going to be sharing the show right afterwards so that people can hear and share this with other people. Especially everyone, please call your insurance company. Also call Carolyn. It's 480-840-1816 on yoursideus.com. If I traded it all, if I could.